sonata in music history. Beethoven's violin and piano sonata number 7 in C minor of 30 number 2. This piece was composed during 1801 to 1802, slightly earlier than his revolutionary and monumental composition Symphony number 3, the Heroic Symphony, which composed during 1803 to 1804 and dedicated to Napoleon Bonaparte. The innovations in this sonata number 7 break through the restrictions imposed by the balance of formal structure in sonata form by expanding the coda section in the first movement of this piece compared with Mozart's sonatas for violin and the piano, K301 and K304. In the turbulent and the storm-like fourth movement, Beethoven creates the innovative dynamic use and compositional pattern with a wide range of dramatic dynamic change. Compositional techniques for altering the part of piano accompaniment and using counterpoints are utilized in the second and third movements. So these innovations profoundly influenced his later works, especially his sonata for violin and piano, number 9, op. 47, also named as Kreutzer sonata, and sonata number 10, op. 96. So, personally speaking, I think good usage of violin bow techniques for interpreting the dramatic dynamic changes and the innovative texture in the first and the fourth movements of this piece is very important and necessary. Meanwhile, this sonata retains the compositional patterns from his early period work, op. 18, number 1, the string quartet, and Haydn's string quartet, op. 76, number 2. For these reasons, I describe this sonata as the bridge between Beethoven's early and his heroic periods that contributes to forming the individual character of Beethoven's music after this sonata number 7 is the manner. Okay, so let's talk about each movement of this piece. The first movement, the formal structure of the first movement is a typical sonata form, consisting of an exposition section, development, retranslation, which is included in development section, recapitulation, and the coda section. The components of this sonata are standard and normal. However, the proportion of sections in the first movement is unusual, particularly in comparison with other movements in sonata form from the classical era. First of all, the scale of coda section in the first movement of this piece, okay, from measure 208 to 254, is expanded. It's unusually larger than other classical pieces. By calculating, this coda section occupies 18.1% in this first movement with 254 measures total. So the function of this expanded coda is not just the decoration as in the codas of the other piece, it has the function of secondary development, and could be regarded as the secondary section individually. For example, the persistently, repeat opening thematic into. It's from the exposition section and other materials from the development in the building part are utilized in this coda. So this coda is not only the strong ending of the first movement, but also works as a restatement of exposition and development sections. The multiple functions and the large scale of the coda are very unusual, and this movement could be regarded as groundbreaking in that era. For comparison, we can examine two typical Berlin sonatas with the standard sonata form against this coda of Beethoven's Sonata No. 7. Okay, so the first example is the first movement of Mozart's Violin and Piano Sonata in G major, K301. So we can see there are 194 measures total. The coda is just 4 bars, so which barely occupies 2% of the entire movement. The other example is the first movement of Mozart's sonata in E minor, K304. So there are 209 measures total. The coda is 6 bars, which occupies 2.8% of entire movement. Furthermore, the coda and development section in this Beethoven sonata are almost equally large. So there are 46 measures in coda section and 49 measures in the development section, including the part of retranslation. So that's the reason why I propose that we could look upon this expanded coda as an individual secondary section. So this kind of formal structure is extremely unique in the early 18th century compared with typical classical pieces. Next, due to expanded coda section, the transitional balance point of the formal structure was altered in this piece. Before Romantic period, most composers intentionally or unintentionally conformed to the rule of golden section. So, particularly in pieces with sonata form. So, what is the golden section? The golden section is a guide to proportion originally applied in ancient architecture and the fine art. So here is the two examples. In the fine art, Fibonacci spiral is widely used for assisting us artists to construct the proportion of the picture. Okay, so the other example is the architectural proportion of the Greek pattern perfectly shows the proportion of the golden section. So we can see the height of the pillar occupies dotted 6:1:8 ratio of height of this entire building. So there are two most important numbers, ratio numbers regarding the golden section, which are dotted 3:8:2 and dotted 6:1:8. So, for example, so in the first movement of Mozart Piano Sonata in B flat major, K333, so there is 165 measures total. The end of the exposition section is read on bar 63, which happens to conform the critical proportional point of the golden section. The calculating formula is like this. 165 equal measures multiplied solid 382, almost equal 63. Yeah, that is the measure at the end of exposition. So the other example is the first movement of Mozart variant concerto number 5 in A major. So there are 226 measures totally, but it doesn't include the cadenza section. Multiplied dotted 618. So we got this number 140. So which is very close to the beginning of the recapitulation measures, the measure 144. So if we use this formula to calculate the first movement of Beethoven Violin Sonata number 7, it doesn't conform to any ratio of golden section. By calculating the first number we got is measure 97, but there is nothing significant in the middle of the development. The second measure we have got is 157. There is nothing significant in recapitulation section either. Although there are the significant innovations in this first movement of Beethoven Sonata number 7, we can still find a couple of elements which are inherited from traditional pieces of usual pattern. For example, in traditional pieces of classical music, the opening thematic motif is usually repeated between different instruments or registers to reinforce the statement of the opening theme. The opening theme usually consists of two-bar motif that repeat once, plus a four bars followed by a four bars phrase. So this kind of compositional pattern appears in the first movement of Haydn string quartet of 7-6 number 2, the Quinton string quartet. There are two bar motif repeat once and followed by one phrase. Okay. The other example, the components in the opening passage in the first movement of Beethoven's Sonata number 7 are similar to the other piece which was composed in his early periods. This piece, the Beethoven's string quartet of 18, number 1. So we can see two bars motif, nearly repeat once, and followed by four bars phrase. Quite similar. Let's move on to the second movement. The opening theme of second movement is introduced by piano, which is similar to the opening theme of the first movement. When the violin comes in to play the theme, the right hand of piano synchronously play with the violin part in the same aspect of rhythm and shape of melody for setting up the quiet, slightly dolorous scenario. However, the recapitulation section, starting from bar 60, it brings a completely different auditory and emotional experience to the audience. Although the notes and the rhythm of the melodic theme which is played by Berlin are almost the same as the opening theme in the Berlin part, the piano plays a rapid scale 30 seconds instead of synchronously following the shape of the magnetic line of violin cards. The piano keep pushing violin forward to make a brighter, more dynamic, and hopeful sound quality until bar 68. Meanwhile, the emotion keeps stacking up to build this enthusiasm, scenario. So this kind of innovative compositional technique for altering the part of piano accompaniment is also utilized in the first movement of Beethoven's Violin Sonata No. 10 of 96, which was written in 1812, 10 years after this Violin Sonata 7. For example, the opening theme in the first movement of Sonata No. 10 opens with a poco allegretto tempo in calm mood. In the allegro coda section, this opening theme reappears on the right hand of the piano from bar 245 to 260. So the rhythm passage on the left hand of piano is twice fast as in the openings of this movement, so which result in a different feeling and emotion. So we can compare this accompaniment part. The third movement. The third movement is a typical compound ternary form with the style of scale. Beethoven innovatively blends contrapuntal composition techniques, especially introduced the concept of staccato into the trio section from measure 49 to 63. The concept of the staccato means the overlapping of statements of a subject or motif with another subject or motif. In this case, we can say the motif is overlapped by the other one and the left hand of piano part when this motif has not been finished yet. According to Kramer's statement in his article, Beethoven conceded to get the canon past the fourth measure of the trio section, completing the phrase in three two-part counterpoints. So this kind of contrapuntal technique also appears at the exposition section of the third movement of Beethoven's Kutscher Sonata. So the fourth movement is in the typical sonata rondo form. It's a special rondo compared with other classical pieces because this rondo movement is in an intense storm-like or turbulent style with the emotion of the anger instead of the dance-like style or minuetto style of the most rondos in Mozart's music, such as the third movement of Mozart's Violin Concerto No. 3 and No. 5. In terms of Dr. Shapiro's description in his dissertation, sinister repeated chords gave way to sudden bursts, and Beethoven instills a fairly rhythmic instability by measuring out the preparatory repeated chords. The sudden silence after gestures coiled tightly with energy are reminiscent of the mood of the first movement. a lot of dramatic dynamic changes persistently appearing throughout the entire movement. All the dynamic changes are subtle, which is rare to see in classical pieces. Consequently, it's a tremendous challenge for both pianists and violinists to interpret these subtle dynamic changes effectively. It requires performers to keep 100% concentration all the time. Piano players must suddenly change the sounding point between the bridge and the fingerboard, the ball speeds, ball pressure, and ball distribution in the brain of when they play these subtle dynamic changes. And the other interesting spot of this fourth movement is the special compositional pattern used. By comparing Beethoven's violin sonata number 7 with the first movement of his Husserl sonata, both pieces use the same compositional pattern at the end. Right before the stormlike or intense coda with the presto tempo, so there is a quiet ending of the last recapitulation with a slow tempo and peaceful sound quality, creating the extremely dramatic contrasting. So in the Husserl sonata, so this kind of composition part appears also. So the peaceful ending followed by very fast presto tempo coda and with an intense emotion. So this kind of compositional pattern normally happens in the compositions of Beethoven's heroic and later period. For example, it also appears right before the coda of the fourth movement of Symphony No. 9. So in Beethoven's violin and the piano sonata number 7, so we can find the traces from Haydn and his early works according to Josef Herman's statement. His early achievements as composer and performer show him to be extending the Viennese classical tradition that he had inherited from Mozart and Haydn. Nevertheless, Beethoven's compositional innovations in the balance of formal structure, dynamic application, and figuration, and the style profoundly impact his later works. It still can be regarded as the significant bridge connecting to the following masterpieces of Beethoven. So now I will play this whole piece with the fantastic pianist Chen. Thank you.
Thank you.